Hi, it's Fab Paulie here. Welcome back to BizJet TV, and today's episode is another accident. This time we're going to talk about a Challenger 604 that crashed at Birmingham Airport just after takeoff in January 2002. But before we get into the accident, I would just like to encourage you to subscribe to BizJet TV if you haven't done so already. We'd love to hear from you in the comments below and give us a thumbs up at the end of this. And please share these videos on BizJet TV. The purpose of the channel is to inform people about business aviation, tell you all about how to buy an aircraft, how to lease an aircraft, how they operate the different types of airplanes, the problems with the pilots with different types of airplanes, how they behave, accidents and, you know, news and all sorts of good stuff here. So have a look around. If it's your first time on BizJet TV, have a look around at the other videos, and I'm sure you'll find them interesting. So let's get straight into today's episode. So January 2002, a Challenger 604 built by Bombardier flew in from the United States into Birmingham with two passengers and three pilots. Two pilots were flying, one was on the jump seat. He was tagging along to gain some experience with flying across the Atlantic. So that's why they had the third pilot with them. They checked into the hotel. Next day they went to the airport. It was bad weather. There was ice on the wings. The pilots decided not to de-ice for some reason. And off they went, tearing down the runway, lifted off, and about 30 feet, the airplane did this. So basically one wing stalled and the airplane turned upside down and crashed and killed the people on board. So this is what happened. Now, the question is, what was the cause of this accident? Now, National Transport Safety Board looked into it. What they discovered is that the pilots had taken a sedative the night before to sleep, and they also had drunk some alcohol. They reckoned that this impaired the judgment of the pilots a little bit. So when the airplane did do that after takeoff, their reflexes weren't quite there. But I think the problem is before that. I think that the reason the accident happened was the lack of knowledge about icing on behalf of the pilots. Now, these were experienced pilots, but experience doesn't necessarily mean you know what you're doing. Because if you fly for 10,000 hours in a bad way or to a low standard and survive, yes, you do have 10,000 hours experience, 20 years of flying. But if that is bad experience repeated over 10,000 hours, what really is important here is performance and knowledge and doing the right thing. Now, what a lot of people don't know, and some pilots don't even know this, and this is really, really important. I mean, what I've learned in my career, what I was taught, and what I've always applied as a rule, when in doubt, always de-ice. Now, de-icing does cost money, and some airports it can be quite expensive, but again, you don't want ice forming on the wing of the aircraft. Now, the important thing is when the pilot does a walk around that they actually touch the wing to see what the situation is. Maybe call the de-icing guys who are kind of experts in this, ask their opinion. But when you're in doubt, you need to de-ice. And I'll tell you why, because even a very tiny, small part of ice on the wing, I mean, if you take sandpaper, for example, medium grade sandpaper, so which is not very thick, just that medium side sandpaper thickness will change the stall speed of the aircraft by a whopping, yes, a whopping 15 knots. Yes, 15 knots. So, and some of this ice, especially if it's at night and you're looking out the window, you're not really going to see it. So you really need to go out and have a walk around, touch it with your hand, not with your glove, with your hand and whatever. Call the de-icing guys. And if you are in doubt, you need to de-ice. This accident happened because the pilots decided not to de-ice, and it's not the only one. There's a lot of other accidents that have happened throughout the history of aviation, both in the airlines and also in the private jet space. So it's very, very important to de-ice because icing, as I said, even just a few millimeters of ice on the upper part of the wing can change the stall speed by 15 knots. And as you're rotating an aircraft up, you've got a high angle of attack. And you know, if you don't know, but to stall an airplane, you need a high angle of attack. And so, you know, some pilots think that they can just slam a load of thrust on and that will still get them up in the air. But they don't realize that the stall is a function of your angle of attack. Even if you've got full thrust, but you lift up, what happens is, you know, the air coming over the wing is, because of the angle, is no longer coming over the wing like it should, and that's when the airplane loses lift and does this. And that's exactly what happened in this case. One wing stalled before the other, and the airplane did that just after liftoff, and the airplane turned upside down and crashed. So you don't want that happening to you. So if you are operating a private jet and your pilot says, boss, we need to de-ice, and of course, de-icing takes time, 15 to 20 minutes to de-ice the airplane, and it obviously costs money as well. Please don't cut corners. Don't try and go cheap. Take your time, because safety is really, really important. I mean, if you don't get the other end, or you get the other end in half a piece, not in one piece, you know, that's not the point. You really do need to play safety here. So again, it's very important that your pilots are trained and know all about icing and de-icing, and that they are also up to date with the new information that's coming out, and they're always discovering new things about weather and whatnot. And it's very important that you send your pilots along for these training courses every six to 12 months, so that they are at the forefront with all the information and whatever. And if you can provide them with good technology instrument wise, that's good too. So that's all about this accident. So sad thing that happened, but you know, as I said, de-icing is really, really important. And if you haven't subscribed to BizJet TV, I encourage you to subscribe, like this video and share this video. And that's all from Fab Pilot BizJet TV, and I'll see you on the next one.